Hi, I am Chandan Kumar. Thanks for joining me in this video. Today, we are going to discuss how we can create very insightful assignments within the Google Classroom platform. In the previous video, I have discussed how Google Classroom as a whole is work, how many functions and tools are there. Since last 12 years, now the digital technology have been changed, and I'm very amazed how quickly it's transforming the learning management system and helping teachers to deliver the classes online. And it's all been possible by the innovation of the Google Classroom. So let's jump in and see how we can create very insightful assignments and assign to students within Google Classroom. So let's go to our Google Drive, where I have created the folder for us to create the assignment. So CGTI assessment paper. Here I can choose all the modules are here, all the courses. So let me select one module where I'm going to create the assignment. So I want to create AP1. So since we already have the questions, let's see how we can create. So I will be at the same drive, and I can right click. This is my first option, and I can go to Google Form. When you go to Google Form, you can start from blank form, or you can choose from template. So I can start and choose from template. This is one way you can save a little bit of time. So here you see many templates are ready. This is from the Google. So I can just take the assessment form and open it. I off my camera here, so okay, never mind. So you see the assessment template have been open, so just I will copy paste my old one. So first, of course, we need to write the name. So I can copy, Control A, copy. And then I can go and change here. Just do the formatting. You can write the name. I can also create which batch. So all the time I just need to copy and change the batch number. And here is competency code. First is, of course, we need to keep name, and this one keep selected as required. Then email. So this is ready-made form. You can just write. I'm using just to save the time. So question. We'll start with the question one. Question one is, you can add this information as well. Like I want to add date. I can just go back and add date. I need to add new template as date. So it's automatic selected as date format. So I can put it up after the email. I need date to feed by students. This one also we can select as required. Then we can start with the question number one. So my course, this also description, if you want to put 1, 2, 3, 4 also we can copy and put. Add here in the description. So I can put description and can do formatting also as well. If I want, I can put on Control B to it become bold. There is formatting you can do as well. So I can keep like this. So this is my description, name, email, date. Now go to first question. So here is, I want to assign 2 marks for this question. So what I will do? First, assigning the marks, I need to go and change the setting of Google Form. So what I need to do, I need to go on setting and setting few things you need to be mindful. If your students are out of your organization, like if they use personal Gmail, so I need to keep unchecked, otherwise they cannot participate. So make sure you keep unchecked all, and then you go to the next menu tab, which is presentation. Here you can select if you want to show them progress bar, or you want to shuffle question, means one student, the question number 5 will come first, question number 4 will come later, so you can put shuffle question. Mostly if your students are sitting together, so you can check on shuffle question, means the number will be automatically switched. So if I don't want, I can uncheck. Then we'll go to the next menu bar, which is quiz. Here you need to put it as a quiz. Then only you will have option for option to assign how many marks you want to give. Respondent can see missed question, correct answer, point values. You can keep uncheck and then save. Look like this is not so this one is not a question format, so you can't take. So I delete this one and I will start from here. So you must have this menu bar to assign the number, like here I can see, and this is multiple choice, so I can change to paragraph to have the big answer. Then I can go to answer key, and here it will ask how much point you want to assign. So this, since this is 2 marks, so I can click on 2 and then done. So this, you can also type answer for your reference if you want to see that, okay, what was the answer for this. So I can write here what is the purpose of grading. So when I check, I see the answer as well, and according to that, if a student have been answered, I can grade. So that is very handy option for teachers as well. Now I will go to second option, second question. So second question is this. So I can just paste second question, and this one also I can change to paragraph. Points I want to change, I can go here and choose 3 grade points because I want 3. Next question, similarly we can go and copy question number 3. So here is ABC question, how we'll do now, ABCDE. So for this I can create different kind of, like we can create a title. So put the title as a this. And then based on that we can create questions here. So this is my title, then I can put the question A. So this is my question A. Right, how many marks? Total is 6 marks. So I have 6 questions, so it means 1 mark each question. So I can just go to answer key and assign 1 mark. So I have the title and I can, one more thing, now you see next I don't have question. So what I will do, either I can add from here, add question, or I can just duplicate it. So duplicate, what we have the benefit, we have everything copied, like 1 point, paragraph and question. Question we can change it later. So let me see, copy. So you see the same question have been copied here. So I will just go and choose the B. I can write B. So I have second question, then go to next. See, there is no bullet points, but maybe in future you will have all copied, 1 points, paragraph, copy to D. And later I will tell you how to check the grading. So all the questions are ready. Now I want to create new question, or we also can create section. So this one was under question number 3, right? And this one also a student, no need to answer. This is a description. This one is only a description. So it's like a section. So I can create one more here, add section. So when I will create, this one bring in, you can create a section as well if you want to ask any question which have multiple. Instead of description you can add section. Like this also you can do, and then start the question A, B, C, D. So this one will be more better than creating a title. So I can just go and delete this. Then I can add another section for our next question. We can write also section. This section is about drafting procedure and basic pattern. So this one will be more better. This section is here. I can just put it, move section, and then bring it down. So this section possibly come down.
Yeah, this one I am the one who copy, right? So when you copy section, is bring, what happened? Let me go back and check. So this one I want to move down. Something weird is happening. I'm going to delete and I will go click here and add section. So this section come down already. So I copy it, drafting and basic pattern blocks. Then I can add question. So under three, this one, I have one question. So I can just copy all. Neck t-shirt and pull over. So I have two garments here to ask the answer. Change to paragraph. Point, this one is four points, four marking. So I can just change to four. Done. Okay. Question 5, let me quickly question all, copy. Question 5. Question 6. So one thing you need to remember, like this is 4 point, and when I go here, this also selected 4 point, but we want how much? Only 3 points. So I can just go here and change 3 points. Similar to that, this one also 3 point. So since we copy from up, we need to edit. So careful when you are seeing the points. So number 6, number 7. Here also we want two kind of answer. Copy. Here you can't enter the in future you will have the facility to put number 1, number 2 and take the bullet points. So it's a development phase. So this also 3 point, I keep the same. Question 7, go to question 8, only 2 points. So I change the answer key to 2. This one is 4 point. Okay. So that's all. My assessment is ready. So we can see there are three sections. One is starting, name, email, date. We want to add venue, you can also do that. Just click here and add. So the new will come up, venue. So I want the student, need to write venue, so venue come also. Date, then questions has started. Before question start, if you want to add section also you can do that, right? And then question 1, 2, this one is unwanted, so I can delete. and then three have multiple questions, so I create a section and then ABCD questions, and each we can check have the markings. So this is how our question done. Now I can send to students. Before sending, make sure you view how a student will see your question. So I can just go on the view preview. You see the I button, you can click here and you can see preview how your student can see your question. So there is written assignment, apparel production sequence. They need to fill name, email, venue, date, then questions start, question 1, question 2. It's saying before, because we put the, they need to write their name and then only they can go to the next. So this is how we preview. So maybe I can put my name, my email, venue I can create CGTI or factory name, we'll do that later, date. So I can select okay, date is today. Answer for my grading, right? Grading is important for creating size set pattern. All size pattern. Fabric utilization, any three, I can just keep any answer, right? Okay, then I can go to next and preview. So question 3, this one was my heading, applicable for both t-shirt and pull short for mass production. So I can answer what is this t-shirt type, for the shoulder seam, for hem, right, like this. Side seam. So you can answer yourself and check one time. Then we can just any for sake of checking, I can answer all and then submit. I cannot see the score unless my trainer have been graded, right? Okay, so this is how we done. I can go back here on the assessment, right? Okay, so we were left here. I can see I have one response from the student and what they have answered. As a teacher, if I want to give grading, I can go to the question and I can find the student name. Oh, we need to go to individual to see the name, and from here I can give the score. So these are all zero, so it's non-graded question. Here is 2. I can check the answer and I can put the grade. Okay, 1 or 2. This is out of 2, maybe 1 only. So I can grade. Just read the answer and grade. This one, suppose wrong answer, I want to give feedback. I can also feedback to a student. Please check your learner guide. So each student, you can also give the comments. And then I can save. So you see my feedback have been saved. then I can continue or the marking. So each student can have mark on the Google Classroom. Here I can comment, you have missed. So I can see, just very handy to see the answer and comment. Then save. And I can see all the answers have been saved. I can send to them. No, not send from here. I can we cannot send from here. We need to send from Google Classroom. So for adding the Google Classroom, what I can do, there are few ways to add this assessment in the classroom. So suppose I want to add, so I need to have the link. One way, we can send email and do that. Second way, we can create link. So this is the link. I can just directly go and paste. So either you can copy all and or you can sort it. Sort is more organized. So I just click on sort and then I can copy. And then I can go to the classroom. This is assessment for apparel production sequence. Make sure you change the heading also. So you can find your assessment for all your classes. So just need to copy the link, right? Okay, now I can go to find my class apparel production sequence. I have many classes, so you might have few less or more. So find apparel production sequence. So this is my class apparel production sequence. I can go to classwork. I can create topic as assignment first. So topic have been added here. Now here I can create again. There are many way to have the assignment. You can assignment from Google Doc, or you can have quiz assignment. So since we creating quiz assignment, I will create on quiz assignment. Then I can type the assignment title AP1. Right. And instead of creating blank quiz, you can add from Google Drive or link. So since I copy the link, what I will do is I will add link. So this one was my link for the Google form. So that link will assign here, you see. Then I can delete and my link is here. So whoever students are in my classroom, I can assign from here. So my assignment is here. So if any students are in my classroom, all students can see the assignment. So when they participate as a teacher, I can go to grade and I can see AP1 assignment, how many students have been answered. Okay. One more thing is very important. Let me go to edit and explain you. So AP1, here are some more explanation or functions. So do you want to assign for all student or selective student? So you can select here, okay, I don't want this particular assignment for all student, I want only on selective. So you can create multiple assignment for different students if you want. So I want this for all students, so I keep selected all student. Now here is point. How much total grade point you have assigned for this? So I can see, okay, how much my total grade. So if I'm not wrong, it was only 30 grade points. So only total numbers, how many? Okay, no problem, I can see from here as well. Total marks. Total marks here is 30 point. You can see here 30 points. So I can go in my classroom and assign 30 points. We can also select date when we want them to answer. So I can find the date. Suppose I don't want the student answer this after 31st. So I can select after 31st. I can also choose the time. I want the answer before 12 p.m. So I can just write and select. The topic is assignment. I can create the assignment. Rubric is a bit more very advanced tool. I will later teach you how to create rubrics. Rubrics basically we use to guide the student what are the criteria for answering the question. So this is also very effective tool. You can also check plagiarism. If you check this, the Google Classroom will tell you how many students have copied from internet. So this is very handy tool also to use. If any student copy answer from internet, it will tell how much they copied, from where they copy. So these are the some additional function, then I can save. So my assignment have been updated here. So we already check how to grade, how to put assignment, and how to assign. So the same assignment, if I want to assign on different course, or I have created the new course. One more function is very handy. Let me teach you how to do. Suppose this apparel sequence, you have another batch. So this one I can copy apparel production sequence, this one, right? So this I want to, this one, let me change the detail. This is for batch 8. So I can add it. This class is for my batch 8. And then some functions are here. If you want to send the class link, you can copy and send directly from here. You also can show the code from here. So in the class, or you share this link, so they can just directly key in their Google Classroom, in a student's personal Google Classroom. Also, if you don't want to create link all the time for the virtual meetings, so you can create a permanent link for this class. Before this, let me show you, here is no link. Here no link, right? So you want a permanent link for the online training. So you can just create generate link and visible to students. So this link will be permanent. So every day this student come, click and join. So we were talking about how to copy class. So I will go to classes again. And you see three dots. You can just click and copy. So I can copy the complete class and I can change it is for batch 9 and then copy. So it will take a few seconds 10-15 seconds, it will copy based on how big the classroom is, how many. So I can see here my class has been copied. I want to change name, I can change, it's still in creating. So I don't want copy of, I can just directly go to setting and then remove the copy, then save. So this is for batch 9 I have created. All the classwork is same, there is assignment, there is course note, everything same. But one thing is different is there are no student. So you can share this link and add a student. So this is completely new class. And grades, once they join, a student's name will be here. So for our, just for checking, let me add some of the student. Go to people, add a student. I can add, type the email directly. And then invite. So once a student at the classroom after invited link, then you can see in the grade they have assigned all the assignments. So Petra, can you join this class for me?
Hello Petra, I think you already go to test.
Oh, okay, then I add you. Okay, so when you join, all the assignments will be assigned for you. So please join and let's see how the assignments goes. When you will go to your email, you will see the I have requested you to join the class. We have almost done only few minute, 2-3 minute we complete this training.
Okay, so receive.
Okay, you join the class. Already joined?
Yeah.
Okay, so here is active as a student. So when I will go to grade, I can see this student have assigned. So before, when you create new class, all will be in draft. So you need to go and post. You need to assign. So how we can do? We can go to edit and
I cannot see anything. You not yet assigned, right?
Yeah, I'm going to assign now. So you see the screen. When I will assign, you can see the assignment. So now I can see your name and the assignment. Can you see?
Yeah.
Right. So it's very easy. So when you create new class, you need to all the file will be draft form, so you need to go and post and assign. So that's how we done. So hope you learn from this activity. So I'm going to stop present. You can watch the videos again and go through this.
Okay.
Any question?
Okay, thank you. We'll go through your record with all.
Okay, thank you. But did I record? Yes, I do, I think.